allow you to beg. Yes. I'm happy to see you too. Thank God we are able to meet and to talk about you. Thank God for everyone in the online class. Happy to see you. Today we are going to study mathematics. Mathematics. Okay? And in our math class today, we are looking at basic multiplication without regrouping. Basic multiplication without regrouping. I say it again, basic multiplication of numbers without regrouping. What are our learning objectives? Our learning objectives for today include to identify basic multiplication of two digits without regrouping. Identify basic multiplication of two digits without regrouping. Without regrouping. Are we clear? Beautiful. Now, the second objective for today's work is to be familiar with the multiplication table. We have to be familiar with the multiplication table. Is that clear? Objective of today's lesson is to be able to identify and work out basic multiplication of two digits without regrouping. And then we are also going to familiarize ourselves with the multiplication table. Are we clear? Are we clear? Beautiful. So let's move on. So what do we mean by multiplication of work without regrouping? Multiplication of two digits without regrouping. Regrouping means carrying. Carrying means renaming. Renaming means carrying. Carrying means regrouping. Regrouping means carrying. Carrying means renaming. Okay? Are we familiar with that now? So when we say without regrouping, it means without carrying. Without carrying. Are we clear? So let's look at what we have. What is multiplication of numbers? What do we mean by multiplication of numbers? This is when we arrange a sum, the sum of a number with itself a specified number of times. And how do we do that? Look at this example. 5 times 4. 5 times 4 will give us 20. Okay, so we count 5 in how many groups? In 4 groups. 5 in 4 groups, which means this is the arranged sum of number by itself a specified number of times. 4 times in 4 groups, in 4 sections. You arrange a number by itself as the same number in that group, in different groups of 4, 5, or as stipulated or specified. Do you understand? Do you understand? Beautiful. Now let's move on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Are we together? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will give us 20, meaning 5 times. 5 times. 5, 5, 5 in 4 different groups will give us 20. Are we clear? Are we clear? Beautiful. Now, let's move on. Now, let's look at show working without regrouping. We show the working of two digits multiplied by one digit without regrouping. Showing the working for 24 times 2. Are we together? Are we together? So we were saying that we show working in which example? In the example of without regrouping, meaning without parrying, without renaming. Okay? So when we do that, let's look at 24. 24 is two digits. 24 is a two-digit number. And 2 is a single digit. So 24 times 2 is 48. How did we get that? We count 4 in a specified number of times, which is in two groups. In two groups, okay? So, we move on. Forty-eight is a two-digit number. So we count 4 in two groups. 4 in two groups, which will give us 4 times 2. 4 times 2. Are we together? So if 4 times 2 will give us 8, what is 2 times 2? 2 times 2. 2 in 2 groups. 2 in 2 groups. And that will give us 4. Are we clear? So at the end of it all, we'll have 48. 48. Now let's look at it again. 24 times 2. It means 2 times 4, 8. 2 times 2, 4. 2 times 4, 8. 2 times 2, 4. 2 times 4, 8. 2 times 2 is 4. Therefore, our final answer will be 48. Is that clear? Is that clear? Are we together? Now let's look at the next slide. Basic multiplication of two digits by one digit number. Basic multiplication of two digits by one digit number. And what do we have? 13 times 2. 13 times 2. Remember, 1, 3, 13 is two digits. 13. Okay, let's move on. As we were saying that two digit numbers by one digit number, multiplication of two digits by one digit number. 13 is a two digit number multiplied by 2. Multiplied by 2. Therefore, what we will have is 2 times 3 and 2 times 1. 2 times 3 and 2 times 1. Okay, so 2 times 3 is 6 and 2 times 1 is 2. 23 times 3 will be 3 times 3 and 3 times 2. 3 times 3 and 3 times 2. 3 times 3 will give us 9. And 3 times 2 will be 6. Our answer, 69. 51 is two-digit number. 51 is a two-digit number. 7 is one digit. Therefore, we say 1 times 7 is 7. 7 times 1 is 7. Therefore, We also say 5 times 7 is 35. 5 times 7 is 35. Are we clear on that? Are we clear? Do we understand? Beautiful. Now let's move on to the next slide. In the next slide, we are going to notice or to learn how to work this out carefully. Note that the digits are written under tens and units. The digits are written under tens and units. Are we clear? Beautiful. Are we together? Very good. Now, if the digits are written under tens and units, start your calculations on the unit. Start your calculation on the unit side or the unit section. Start your calculation on the unit. Now, count the upper number under the unit. That is under the unit section or angle. You count the upper number as the specified number given below. Count the upper number as the specified number given below. Then cross count the lower unit digit against the upper tens digit. What would you do next? Write your answer. Write your answer. Very good. Yes? Okay. Now, let's go on. Let's show that on our board. Remember, what we're doing is, multiplication of two digits by one digit number. Of two digits by one digit number. And so we say, yes? Okay, let's go there. Under the tens and the units, now we have tens. Yes. Oh, let's go there. Okay. Let's see. Tens and units. Under our tens and our units, tens and units, we say tens. And our tens and units. What do we now say? Well, under the tens and units, we have the number, let's say 22. Misuse of this application. Okay, let's look at that. 22 times, yes, times 2. Then we have, yes, we have units here, and tens here. Thank you. So if we have tens and units, and we're saying that you should note that the digits The digits are falling under the tenth and the unit. You will know that number two falls under, excuse me, number two here falls under the unit. All right. You will know that number two falls under the unit. Are we together? So we now say, mind you, this is two. Okay, we now say 2 times 2, and in counting we say 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay, so 2 times 2 is 4. Therefore, we go to our answer slot and write 4. Are we together? Then we go again and we say 2 times 2. Okay? Now this 2 times 2 again. Here we say 2 times 2. Okay? Now we go, we say 2 times 2 will also give us 4. Are we together? Very good. So on the board here now we have 22 times 2 will give us 44. Are we clear? Are we together? Okay, let's give another example without regrouping. We're working with without regrouping. Is that clear? Do we understand? Without regrouping. That is our subject matter for today. Our topic for today, without regrouping. Now let's try out some other examples. Let's look at other examples as we move there. Sharp matters. Yes. Okay. Now, let's go. Our tens and our units. Okay, now let's say 1, 4, very good. 1, 4 times 2 times 2. Which will be equals to, okay. Now, what must we do? Observe that the 4 is under the tens unit, the tens section, and the 2 is under the, sorry, observe that the 4 is under the unit section, and the 2 is under the unit section. Are we clear on that? Then the 1 is under the 10. Yes? This is the appropriate way to arrange your multiplication. Is that clear? Now, we now move on to say 4 times 2 or 2 times 4. Are we together? Yes? 4 times 2 or 2 times 1. Are we clear? By the time we arrive at these answers, we'll be able to work out what the total sum of 14 times 2 will be. Are we together? Therefore, we go 4 times 2. 4 times 2 demands that you count 4. How many times? In two groups. 4 in two groups. Therefore, I say 1, 2, 3, and 4. That is first group. We move on to another 4. 1, two, three, and four. Are we clear? Group one, group two. That gives us equals to what? Equals to eight. Because when you count all together, you will have eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Our answer here is eight. You write eight in your answer space because that is the answer. Yes? Beautiful. Now we move on to two times one. Two times one. It now means we count one how many times? Two times. So we say one. Okay? And another one. Count all together. One, two. What is our answer? Equals to. What is the answer? Two. Therefore, our answer will be 28. 28. Do you understand? Do you understand? Always start your calculations from the unit angle. The unit angle. Whatever the place value may be, start from the unit angle. If you have three digits, you must always start calculation at the unit angle. Don't fail to understand that. Is that clear? Beautiful. Let's move on. When you calculate from the unit angle, you then move on to the tenth angle. Remember, the one digit, that one digit must multiply those two other digits above. This one digit must multiply these two digits above. Is that clear? Beautiful. Now let's move on. Let's go back on to our slides. Yes. Let's move on to our slide. So, what are the steps that we took? What are the steps that we took? Note that the digits are written under tenth and unit. Did you note that? Beautiful. Start your calculations on the unit side. Did you do that? Very good. Now, count the upper number under the unit as the specified number of, as the specified given number. Is that clear? Now, cross count the lower unit digit against the upper 10th digit. Do you understand that? Very good. Very well. So, we move on, shall we? Very good. Very, very good. Very good. We want to return to our slide. Is that clear? So what we'll do here is, we pick on our slide, yes? And then we close. That is what we did. So if you followed the steps through and through, you'll find out that what we have done is what is still resting on our board. Is that clear? So now we can return to our slide. Is that clear? Very good. All right. Let's move forward. From this slide now, we now say you must be able to do that without regrouping. And this is further steps to show. 23 times 2. 3 times 2 is 6. 2 times 2 is 4. Write it down. 3 times 2 is 6. 6. Write it in your answer space or your answer score. 2 times 2 is 4. Write it in your answer stop. At the end of it all, we will have 46 as our answer. Correct. 46. Always start calculating from the unit angle, the far right hand side. Okay? Calculate from the far right hand side. Always. Okay. And when you arrive at your answer, please write it down in English language. It is essential and very important for you to familiarize yourself with the multiplication table. It's important that you familiarize yourself with the multiplication table. Where you don't do that, there's an issue. You must be able to master your multiplication table from number 1 to number 12. It will help a lot in this matter. In fact, here forward, we will be needing a multiplication table knowledge, expert knowledge on a multiplication table. So take time out to study your multiplication table, master your multiplication table. Yes, master it. It's essential that you master it. Yes, 1 to 12. I give you an instance. 2 times 1 is 2. 2 times 2 is 4. 2 times 3 is 6. 2 times 4 is 8. 3 times 1 is 3. 3 times 2 is 6. 3 times 3 is 9. 3 times 4, 12. 3 times 5, 15. 4 times 1, 4. 4 times 2, 8. 4 times 3, 12. 4 times 4, 16. You move on in that way until you get to timetable number 12. It will be very, very handy. Now, let's look at multiplication without regrouping and with regrouping. Without regrouping and with regrouping. Master the difference, apply the knowledge. Yes, now, 13 times 2, we said without regrouping means without carrying. With regrouping, it means carrying one. Carrying one. Carrying the number, the remaining number forward. Is that clear? Therefore, we say 13 times 2 is 2 times 3 is 6. Write it down in your answer slot. 2 times 1 is 2. Write it in your answer slot. Is that clear? Answer 26. Always start calculating from the far right hand under the unit section. Are we clear? Then we move on. Are we together? We move on. With regrouping. With regrouping means you carry 1. 3 times 4 is 12. You write down 2 and carry 1. 3 times 3 is 9. Write down 0. Why? Because 3 times 3 is 9. You plus 1. The one that is carried forward from number 12. You add it to 9. 9 plus 1 will give you 10. Now, if the answer is 10, 2 digits, you write down 0 and carry 1 forward. Write down the number in full. Sorry. In this case, we say 3 times 4 is 12. 3 times 3 is 9. Plus 1 is 10. Because there's none other number in front of number 3. It is not a 3-digit number. It is 2-digit number. There is none other thing to add the carried number to. So you relax and write the full number on the answer space. No need to carry because there's nothing to carry forward to. Is that clear? You can't carry 1 to the next number because there's no next number there. Because there's no next number there, we write 10 in full. Therefore, our answer is 102. Always remember the carriage number. Are we together? Are we together? Beautiful. Now, arrange the following numbers in the correct order. Then multiply. 33 times 1, 14 times 5. Becomes 14 on the tens and units. Start on the tens and units. Tens is 1, unit, you put four. Under four, number five is a single unit. So you put it under the unit section, just like it is done here. Is that clear? 33 times one, use the correct order. Arrange in the correct order. 54 times two, 63. Are we together? 63 times four and 15 times five. These are things that you should, at the numbers you should play with, work with it. You understand? Why? Because math is a subject you can kick around like a football. Yes, mathematics is a subject you can kick around like a football. That is it. That is the truth. So work with these numbers and kick it around because it's so simple. As simple as kicking the ball. All right? Very good. Yes. Now, before we go, let's see a shared slide where we have to work out. Yes, let's work out the carry with remainder. So we go tens and units. Don't mind my writing. Pardon my writing. Okay, then we say 33. Sorry, let's get this thing cleaned up. Okay. Let's come back. Our tens and our units. Okay, then we say 33 33 times 5, or let's say times 4. Okay, there we go. Okay, 3 times 4 is 12. 12. Write down 2. Okay, we write down 2. Carry 1. Okay, when we carry 1, 3 times 4 is 12. We say 12 plus 1. 3 times 4, 12 plus 1 equals to 13. Are we clear? 13. Are we together? Pardon my number 3? Okay. Yes. So, let's try 3 again. Okay. So we say 13. That's better. Why? Because we have said 12 plus 1. We said 12 plus 1. 3 times 4 is 12 plus the carried 1, which will give us 13. It will give us 13. And that is why we have 13 written as our answer. Is that clear? Beautiful. Thank you. Thank you so very much for joining us in this online class. Thank you so very much because we have enjoyed our time with you. Thank you for being such a wonderful student. Thank you, and please ensure that you stay safe. Yes, you keep safe and stay safe. Yes, thank you for the effort you have put in. And remember, evaluate yourself at the end of this class. Thank you, until we see you another time. Make sure you do more practice at home. And please, remember, mathematics is a subject you can just kick around. You can kick it around like a football. Thank you very much. Thank you for being online. I've enjoyed my time with you. I hope you stay blessed. Stay healthy.